We have a big theme in our building this year of noticing the need and meeting the need. We don't always know what we need to meet that need, but noticing the need of, okay, my child is feeling disconnected from their peers or from school, or coming back to school is really hard. We've been at home for several months, and there's been a lot of comfort in that for some, just kind of depending, and just coming back has been challenging and has surfaced a lot of things that are new. And so identifying those or noticing those and then reaching out when you do see them. I feel like quarantine, when we kind of all were forced to go inward, we had a lot of opportunity to spend time with our families and inside of our homes, which was great. And I think there were so many wonderful things that came out of that. But then that has kind of created a little bit of a gap or some separation with like the outside world, or coming back into school and feeling that connection with peers, and for like our online kiddos, feeling that connection with their classmates virtually. Noticing when there's a little bit more withdrawal, or, you know, for small children, usually behavior is their communication. So if their behavior is changing, they are more verbal, or something might be happening at home, or they're refusing to do things more than prior, all of those are signs to just kind of keep your eyes open to. Going out into the community in ways that you feel comfortable and safe, going out on walks, getting in touch with nature. I feel like it's kind of that quality over quantity, in a way, is a great way to focus on that connection piece and where you can find what maybe you or your child is passionate in and get them more involved in that. There's a quote that I really loved. It was all about, you know, life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you respond to it, which I still believe and agree with to a certain extent, but I've definitely shifted my thinking on that quote because I feel like we had a lot of life in the last several months, and I don't want to minimize that 10%. I think life is 100% what happens to you and 100% how you respond to it is kind of how I've shifted my thinking. Self-care, to me, you know, I think is priority number one, even though that might not be where it falls within us and how we respond. If we don't take care of ourselves, then we're not going to be in a place where we can take care of others and our loved ones. Doing like a check-in of our mind and our body and just how we're feeling, and if we notice something that is not serving us, for me, I know breathing really helps, and it doesn't have to be this big like meditation or production of breathing. It's just even within, like as I'm walking down the hall, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna take in and inhale, like I need to give myself some grace, and then I'm gonna let go of the things that aren't serving me and try to just release that in a productive way.